Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost, and after that, all our brothers and sisters that have been supporting the da'wah. The OMF channel has reached 100,000 subscribers and more with your support. Jazakumullahu khairan. You kept sending us donations. I didn't take a single penny. We do this for Allah. But what did we do? We bought equipment, we bought material, we had more money left over. We got a sign. Allahu Akbar. We continue the da'wah now 24 hours a day. People driving by will know that Jesus was a Muslim because he submitted himself to Allah, as we are Muslims who submit ourselves to the same Allah that sent Jesus and Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon them. Those that are trying to take shots at us, that are gunning for us, you're shooting blanks. Apostate Prophet, the Princess, you want to come and debate? Come face to face to Balboa Park. This is going to be called the graveyard for Islamophobes' careers. Come and get your career ended. Alhamdulillah, Allah will continue the da'wah, and we ask Allah to accept it from all of us. Allahu Akbar.
Hello people, this is Socrates Shan. First of all, we accept. In the course of the next month, I will find the most popular videos of this charlatan, and I will refute every word he says. In this video, we will investigate whether Jesus was a Muslim. Let's compare the real Jesus in popular culture with the Isa in the Quran. First of all, the word Isa in the Quran comes from the word Isus, a translation of the Greek word Isus. Now, you will wonder why God translates the Greek name of Jesus into Arabic instead of using a translation of the original name he gave to Jesus in Hebrew and Aramaic. Yeshua means Yah saves. Yeshua equals Yahuwah equals Yah plus Shua. Yah in short for Yahweh, and Shua is from Yeshua, which means to save, save alive, rescue. In other words, the more appropriate translation for Jesus' name is God rescues. Something that makes perfect sense in the Christian conception of Jesus and makes little sense in the Islamic conception of Jesus. But who knows, maybe Muhammad, that came 600 years later and didn't even know how to pronounce the name of Jesus, knows better who Jesus was than his contemporaries. Being an atheist, I will approach this issue from an objective, impartial scope. In popular culture, Jesus, among other things, was a prophet, a man of God, a man that preached God. Like all other prophets, like Moses, Muhammad, Joseph Smith, and all the other prophets in human history. What distinguished Jesus from all other prophets is that Jesus was also the God-man. Islam denies Jesus being God, so it strips Jesus what separates him from all the other prophets. Also, Islam denies the crucifixion. The cross in Christian theology is essential for salvation, and it's a central symbol of what Jesus came to do on earth. Islam denies Jesus' sacrifice for humanity and presents Jesus in the likes of John the Baptist. In Islam, the only good thing Jesus ever did, in hindsight, is prophesizing the coming of Muhammad. Other than that, Jesus in Islam is a total failure, as he accidentally made Christianity that kept more people away from the true God than any other institution in human history. Isa in Islam, although having the best intentions, he was a total failure. Oopsie, I just created Christianity that kept more people away from the true God than any other person in human history. And what did I do in my life? Nothing. I just prophesized Muhammad. Even in the cross, I cowardly escaped death. And I let another person die in my place. Now, you tell me if that is not the most antichrist religion imaginable. Okay, sophisticated, attacking the essence of Jesus, and leaving all the rest. Look what Islam is doing. Is sophisticatedly attacking the essence of Jesus, and taking advantage all the rest of Jesus. Okay. So, if I was not an atheist and I was religious and I believed in the supernatural, Islam is clearly from Satan. Let's continue. Jesus established on this earth a church and then claimed that he loves his church like a husband loves his wife. Islam prosecuted and attacked Jesus' church more than any other force in human history. Islam actively, as we speak, and historically, more than any other force in human history, is trying to destroy the church of Jesus. Islam, as we speak, tries to erase the memory of Jesus, the print of popular Jesus, and install in its place a skeptro, a straw man of Jesus. Something paradoxical, as even the Quran presents Jesus having all these special qualities that no other prophet possesses. Like, for example, in the Quran, Jesus is the Word of God, pre-existed with Allah in heaven. In the Quran, Jesus was born from a virgin. In the Quran, Jesus has no sin. Jesus and his mother Mary are the only humans that Satan couldn't touch, making them the only humans without sin. The Quran gives a special status to Mary, the mother of Jesus, as it's the only woman the Quran names. In the Quran, Jesus has godlike abilities, like fashioning birds and breathing to them life. In the Quran, Allah saves Jesus from crucifixion and takes him with him to his throne. Jesus in Islam is the only human that, as we speak, he is still alive together with Allah above heaven. Also, the Quran claims Jesus will come back and defeat Satan on the Day of Judgment. But the most important thing for me is that, as I am an atheist, okay? So, whether you believe in Jesus or not, something is absolutely certain, that Jesus was a moral person and a great moral teacher. Jesus practically or metaphorically introduced humanity into religion. God entered into creation and experienced life, and with him, the fragile human soul entered into the social establishment we call religion. God was not anymore something to fear. God became a father, a brother, a friend, or Jesus. Allah, for example, is a calculative robot without soul, incompetent to feel love or empathy. He just sits in his plastic throne and calculates baraka. Okay. Allah and gods in popular religious mythology before Jesus and after have no empathy, okay? They don't have the humanity. They cannot change their mind. They don't jump in the mud to save humans. In the time of Jesus, there were the Pharisees, people that were so strict in enforcing Jewish law that they lost their humanity. Jesus teached against that. Muslim apologists like modern-day Pharisees insist that reason and human emotions should stay away from social life. People who just follow instructions are not moral agents. A robot can be programmed to do moral things, but it's not a moral agent. The same way people who just follow instructions can do moral things, but they are not moral agents. Islam wants to eliminate the humanity out of social life. Whether you believe in Jesus or not, Jesus was an objectively good moral teacher. He introduced morality, humanity, morality in religion. Okay, He introduced love in a religion. He introduced the human, how you say, the fragile human soul to religion. This is what Islam tries to take away. It tries to take away Jesus from religion.
Stone her! Stone her!
Master, what should we do? This woman has been caught in the act of adultery. She should be punished according to the law. What do you say?
Answer, Master. We want to know your opinion.
Yes, tell us. Is it right to kill her?
He among you who is without sin, let him cast the first stone.
Amen. So, look the difference. We don't respect and love Jesus because he is God. We respect him and love him because he is Jesus. Okay, that's the superiority of this person. He's objectively, platonically, objectively a good person. Okay, he's not good because he's God. He's good. Okay, can you understand? That is Jesus. That's very, very important. Okay. Allah claims that you should respect me because I'm God. You don't demand respect. Okay, you cannot force people to respect you. We respect Jesus because he is good, irrespective of if he's God. Okay, that's the majesty of Jesus. Okay, that agrees with secular morality. Okay, that's why we love you, Jesus. Thank you.
And I have asked religious non-Muslims, I'm talking of Christians and Jews and Hindus, etc., naming top pop stars from the music industry. Would you allow your children to listen to this person? Never. Would you allow them this? Never. Would you allow them that? Never. Why? It's dirty, it's immoral, it's filthy, it's degrading, and it's unacceptable, not in my home. But you're a Christian, I know, not allowed. But you're a Jew, not allowed in my home. But you're a Hindu, never, not with my children. Why? Because the industry is dirty, that's what it is. So people argue, no, there is maybe, perhaps, I do agree. Perhaps the doof is permissible within certain limits, within certain limits. Perhaps if you are singing an Islamic song with beautiful meanings, perhaps within limits, there is a certain permissibility. But here I'm speaking of the musical instruments and the music industry, whereby people start shaking. I don't even know what.
When the day is long,
Thank you so much, David.
Well,